I was a wandering soul, traveling a well-worn road, a sinner so far from home, no second chance in sight. I heard you call my name, I felt you lift my...
Hey everybody, we're going to continue our series in 1 Corinthians this weekend. We have so far talked about the gifts of the Spirit. Pastor Jeff talked about how we receive these gifts and we have unity and diversity. All of us have different gifts to share. Last week we talked about unity in body, being a part of the body of Christ. This weekend we're talking about love, the kind of this outward definition of unity. Chapter 13 defines agape love, love that is absolutely unconditional, the love that God has for us. It's a deep chapter, and we have probably been to weddings. Maybe this was read at our wedding. Maybe we've referred to this for other instances, but this is a much deeper passage than what we think. I think we read it and think, yep, you know, I love my family, I love my spouse, I love, you know, the people around me. But this is really deep, more than just surface level love. Love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud. Later on it says, love never fails. Do you have that kind of love? As sinners, it's very difficult for us to love unconditionally. It is, because we allow a lack of patience. We are easily angered at times. But I want to take a look at verse 9 where it says, for we know in part and we prophesy in part. Listen to this. But when completeness comes, what is in part disappears. What is completeness? Completeness is God's love. Completeness is Jesus. When he comes in, when he comes, everything that is in part, that means like my love is in part. It talks about tongues, speaking in tongues, talks about wisdom. It talks about all these things that we desire, and it's all partial. But when completeness comes, all of those things disappear. God is love. This chapter is all about God's unfailing, never-ending, unconditional agape love. And it's much deeper than what we probably have imagined when we're sitting at a wedding and listening to it. I encourage you this week, as you consider what this chapter might mean to you, I encourage you to read chapter 13. There's 13 verses in chapter 13, and it's all about love. And I want you to truly think about the way that love comes from you towards those that are special to you or your spouse, your families, and how you show love. Because if love is patient, when I am impatient, that ain't love. So I have to work on that. I have to try to stifle that impatience, because that's going to interrupt my unconditional love for my loved ones. Brothers and sisters, we have a lot of work to do here on earth, and we are to be used. We can't outwardly love without the work being done in us, and God has this agape, unconditional love for you. And he's doing that work in you so that the work can also be done through you. It's a beautiful thing. It's an incredibly rewarding experience, but it's something that we need to open up our hearts to. So this weekend, I hope you can join us on Sunday as we dive into the love chapter, as Pastor Jeff would say. I want to remind you too, those of you that are members of South Zumbra, we have our annual meeting on Sunday immediately after church. Just a reminder that any voting that happens, you need to be present. You need to be on the church grounds. So we hope you can join us for worship, Sunday school at 9 a.m., worship at 10 a.m., and then of course our annual meeting immediately following church on Sunday. So I hope that you can be warmed this very, very frigid, cold day by the love of those around you, and to truly feel the love of God in your life. I love you, and we'll talk to you soon. God bless.
My life, loving my Jesus, showing my scars.